Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, insertion and action of the sternocleidomastoid muscle.
Pictured here we can see the sternocleidomastoid muscle from an anterior view. This muscle has two heads. It has a sternal head coming down here connecting to the sternum and the clavicular heads coming down here connecting to the clavicle. And both of these heads merge together around here and then continue up towards their insertion point. And we'll be going over the exact origin and insertion of this muscle in just a moment, so stay tuned for that. So I just want to show you a lateral view of this muscle so that you get a better understanding of where it originates and inserts. So we can see the separation between the two heads right here with this black line, and you can see the clavicular head and the sternal head. Let's take a look at the origin points next. So we've swapped back to an anterior view because it's a lot easier to see the origin points from this position. And now you can see those origin points marked out here in red. And we'll start by looking at the sternal head first, which would be coming down this section here. And that's connecting onto the manubrium of the sternum. Manubrium of the sternum would be this top section here, which I'm moving my cursor around. I'll put a little diagram on the screen to better illustrate that. In terms of what part of the manubrium of the sternum it's originating on, we could describe it as the superior and anterior aspect. So the superior aspect would be towards the top, and the anterior surface would be the surface which is facing us right now. Moving on to the clavicular head next, we can see that highlighted here in red. And that's towards the medial part of the clavicle, so medial would be towards the midline of the body here. So if we were going to describe where it's originating from, we could say it's originating on the medial quarter of the clavicle's superior surface. So let's swap back over to a lateral view so we can better see the insertion point next. And now you can see the insertion point highlighted here in blue. We'll start by looking at this section of the insertion, which I'm moving my mouse around here. This would be the mastoid process of the temporal bone, and it's really easy to feel this part of the insertion on yourself. So this little bit here, this little hole, that would be the ear hole. So if you feel slightly behind your ear and then slightly down, you'll feel a bony bump just behind your ear. And if you turn your neck side to side, you'll probably feel your sternocleidomastoid muscle contracting, and you'll feel where the insertion is on that mastoid process. If we're to move a little bit further back and look at this section of the insertion here, this would be on the anterior portion of the superior neutral line. Let's take a look at that in a little bit more detail. So now you can see an illustration that better depicts the superior neutral line. In between the superior neutral line is a landmark which you might have heard of before, the external occipital protuberance. And this is where the neutral ligament that runs down the back of the neck, that's where it inserts onto. And then either side of the external occipital protuberance, that would be the superior neutral line. And that's going to be our insertion point of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. However, bear in mind, the sternocleidomastoid muscle doesn't span the entirety of the superior neutral line. Rather, it just sticks to about the lateral half of the superior neutral line. So around where those two arrows are pointing either side, that would be where the sternocleidomastoid's insertion would come up to. And just for reference, you can see that lateral view of the insertion once again.
So let's take a look at the actions next. So the actions of this muscle are going to depend on whether just one side contracts or both sides contract together. A contraction of just one side of a muscle is unilateral contraction, and a contraction of both sides, that's bilateral contraction. We'll start by looking at the unilateral actions of this muscle first. And our first one is going to be lateral flexion of the neck, which would be tilting to the head to the side just like that. Now, the proper name for that is ipsilateral flexion, because the left side is contracting and the head's tilting across to the same side. The opposite of ipsilateral is contralateral, which brings us on to our next action, which is contralateral rotation. So contralateral rotation because the left side's contracting, but the head's going to the opposite right side. So our two actions for unilateral contraction are going to be ipsilateral flexion and contralateral rotation. But let's take a look at bilateral contraction next. So both sides of the muscle are contracting now. That's going to tilt the head forward, resulting in flexion of the neck. but it can also cause extension of the neck as well. But how does it achieve these two very contrary actions from the same muscle? Well, it's because other muscles can hold the cervical spine in place, and that's going to influence whether flexion or extension occurs. So when other muscles are holding the cervical spine in place, making it more rigid, that's when the flexion of the neck can occur. But when they're a bit more relaxed and not holding the cervical spines quite so rigidly, that's when the extension of the neck can occur. So moving on to our next action now, that's going to be assisting in inspiration. And this is achieved by elevating the clavicle and the sternum, because the sternocleidomastoid is attaching onto both of those points. And that's going to happen when you need to take a really deep breath. It's not going to happen when you're sort of just sitting around doing nothing. It might be when you're quite heavily exercising or something like that. So if you've enjoyed this video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, and let me know what you thought of the video in a comment. It really helps out the channel. Thanks again for watching, everyone. I'll see you all next time.